Welcome back, everybody. Noise in photos is often our enemy, but sometimes we can't avoid it. Maybe because the light is gone, or the subject is moving so damn fast that you need to crank up your ISO to get a sharp shot. Either way, noise sucks. But removing it often comes at a cost, which is the detail in your image. It's really hard sometimes to keep that balance between having no noise in your image, but having a lot of details in your image. Now, Luminar Neo's Noiseless AI Extension is supposed to remove this issue. And even better, it's supposed to do that in basically one click, while keeping a lot of detail. Now, in this video, we will check it out. We'll start with some examples and, of course, how it works, but then we'll also check the other options that are available within Luminar to remove noise and then make a quick comparison. Let's start with how it works. To start, simply head to the top right or left, depending on if you're using Luminar as a plugin or a standalone software, but wherever, and select Extras. There, make sure you pause the video and ensure you are subscribed to this channel. Look, I don't like it either, but this is YouTube and you know the drill. We have to deal with it. Moving on. Now, find the Noiseless AI extension and hit Install, if you have the right subscription, of course. Now, for me, I really want to test here, so I'm going to take an image with both blurry background and detail, like this little fella here to start with. I'm going to go ahead and add 8% of noise to that image in Photoshop. Now, you can clearly see it in the background and in the feathers here. Once we're all done, all set up, we're going to load our image into Luminar Neo and check the right-hand side for the noiseless section. Once you open it up, Luminar will recommend a setting to choose here, low, middle, or high. Let's have some faith and follow and select middle. Now, this is the part I hate a little bit. The weight. Depending on your image and your setup, this can actually take a bit. And then they also add this dumb animation. And this animation actually slows down towards the end, kind of suggesting that it may take up resources just to have that animation on your image. Yes, while we speak, this is still going on. Okay, this aside, we are done, so let's have a look. If we zoom in 100% on the background, we can see that most of the noise is gone. Our bird friend here also looks good if we check the before and after. After the noise removal, I can still see the details in the feathers here. Going a bit lower, we are losing some of the detail in the very dark areas, but are retaining most of the general detail in the bright areas. If we wanted to, we could use the details or sharpness sliders to get more details out of the dark areas and then repeat the noise removal for the background. I'd probably be too lazy, but the option is there. Let's check another photo, one with a bit more detail. Here's a scene from Japan with 8% noise. We have some rain, we have details in the hair here, lots going on. So let's do the same. Head to the extension, and as it recommends middle again, let's use that. Once it's done with its ridiculous animation, we can have a look. Let's start with 200% zoom in on the people. And I have to say, I love the results. I can still see even single hairs. There really wasn't a lot of detail loss, and this is 200%. I usually aim for a noiseless image at about 100% zoom in. Now, if we try that, we can see we even kept the rain here in the dark areas. Now, just for fun, let's take that very same image and add 15% noise to it. And yes, as it's supposed to do, it really screws up the image here. But let's try out the high option within the noiseless section. After it's done, I gotta say, this is ridiculous. It actually got rid of all the noise. Nothing in the background, and while we did lose some detail in the people here, I think it's fair that for that level of noise, we can sacrifice a minuscule amount of detail. Take a look, if we take the image before I added any noise to it and compare it to after Luminar removed the 15%, then it's stupid how we only lost a little bit of detail. For me personally, even though of course there is this weight involved with this stupid animation, but generally I do like what it did here and how it preserved the detail in my images. The alternative before that extension came along was the normal denoise function within Luminar. Let's check that one out, shall we? If we take the image, we add 15% of noise, head to the denoise and crank it up fully. Even with the boost, there's barely anything happening in the picture. That sucks hard. All in all, I think we can say that the extension is an awesome addition to Luminar. It does remove most of the noise while retaining most of my details in the image. Now, whether or not you're a friend of these extensions in general, or if you believe these, you know, extensions should just be normal functionality within the software, of course, that's besides the point because we're just testing, but I can see where you're coming from. If you did like what you have seen and you are thinking about getting Luminar for yourself, make sure you use the link in the description as well as the promo code LETSIMAGE at checkout, not just to support the channel, but also, of course, to save some dinero. We love saving dinero. Thank you for watching, and until next time, have a good one. Bye!